So we have learned how each of these three particles that make up the atom were discovered. Now let's talk about how these three things relate to each other. First thing we're going to look at is the relative masses of these particles. I guess really the first thing we should say is that these are extraordinarily tiny. Protons, neutrons, and electrons, all of them, compared to what we deal with in our everyday lives, they are infinitesimally small. Like, we truly cannot fathom how tiny these things are. They are very, very tiny. Now, with that being said, when we compare inside of these three, the protons and the neutrons are nearly identical in their mass. They are just a little bit off, just a tiny bit different, but for our purposes, we are going to pretend like they are exactly the same. The electron, on the other hand, is about 1/1000th the mass of a proton or a neutron. It would take actually a little more than 1,000, I think about 2,000 actually, something like that, somewhere between 1,000 and 2,000 electrons to equal the mass of a single proton. So the mass of an electron is so tiny, even though it is there, it does technically have mass, it is so tiny that for really the rest of this class, we are going to pretend like it doesn't have mass. We're going to pretend like it is massless. It just makes our lives a little bit easier. Now, you notice there we have the masses shown in kilograms, and that is a perfectly reasonable way of representing the mass of these particles. But scientists decided they wanted to design a new unit when they're discussing the masses of these subatomic particles, which is also completely reasonable, because who wants to have to deal with times 10 to the negative 27 all the time when you're working with masses? And so the atomic mass unit was created. And what the atomic mass unit is it is it is 1/12th the mass of a carbon 12 isotope, which I know is a bit more technical than you want right now. And so for our purposes, we are just going to say that 1 AMU is the mass of a proton or a neutron. As you can see here, it's actually a little bit different than that. They are a little bit more than 1 AMU, but for our purposes, it's going to work pretty well just to say that they are 1 AMU each. And so you notice there that the electron is way down at 0.00055 AMU. In terms of their charge, remember, the protons have positive charge, electrons have negative charge, and neutrons are not charged at all. And the other key thing to notice here is that the proton and electron have exactly the same charge, but opposite in sign. They are exactly the same when it comes to the magnitude of the charge, but they are opposite in terms of their polarity. One is positive, the other is negative. And it's very important that they are exactly the same. If those were not exactly the same, the fundamental laws of the universe would not be what they are. It is very important that those are exactly the same. All right. So just a few other things here that you probably have discussed before in other classes, but when it comes to things that are charged, hopefully you remember that dissimilar charges, so opposite charges, attract each other. So protons and electrons like each other. They are attracted to each other. But like charges repel, so similar charges repel. Two protons don't really like being next to each other, and two electrons don't really like being next to each other. And then the last thing here on this slide is the protons and neutrons cancel each other out in terms of their sign, in terms of the charge. So if you have four protons and four electrons in an atom, your atom is neutrally charged. All right, so let's look at an example here. So this says, an atom composed of which of these particles would have a mass of approximately 12 AMU and be neutrally charged. So why don't you go ahead and see if you can work this out. Pause the video for just a second and try to work out which one of those four possibilities would give you a 12 AMU atom with no overall charge. Okay, I hope you gave that a shot. If we look at the possibilities here, the first option, we have 6 protons and 6 electrons. That would give us a neutral charge, because we have 6 positive, 6 negative, but remember that only protons and neutrons have mass on the order of an AMU. So this would only have a mass of 6 AMU. The next one here has 3 protons and 3 neutrons and 6 electrons. This one is actually really not good, because not only do we not have 12 AMU, because we only have 6 protons and neutrons when you add them together, but we're not neutrally charged either, because we have 3 positive charges and 6 negative charges, so we would have a charge of negative 3, which is not good. The third one here has 6 protons, 6 neutrons, and 6 electrons. Because we have the same number of protons and electrons, that will give us a neutral charge. And because we have 6 protons and 6 neutrons, that will give us a mass of 12 AMU. So this is our answer. This next one here is not correct because it has no positive charge at all. So this would have an AMU, it would have a mass of 12 AMU, but it would have a charge of negative 12, which is a bit different than zero. So that one is not correct. All right, so let's keep talking here about the atom and elements. More specifically here, we're going to talk about how we define an element. Because I know you've heard of things like you've heard of aluminum before, I'm sure. You've heard of carbon, you've heard of hydrogen, all these things, and you might kind of associate those with things on the periodic table, but you've probably never actually heard what actually defines an element. What makes aluminum aluminum? What differentiates it from iron? They're both metals, they're both kind of silvery looking. What is it that makes aluminum different? The answer is the number of protons in the nucleus. The number of protons in the nucleus is the definition of an element. Let me rephrase that a little bit. How we define an element is based on its number of protons in the nucleus. So every atom in the universe that has 13 protons in its nucleus, we define to be aluminum. That is aluminum. Anything that has 13 protons. We don't care how many neutrons it has. We don't care how many electrons it has. If it has 13 protons, that's aluminum. In the same way that everything that has 2 protons is helium. The number of protons defines the element. And this leads us to the periodic table. Because if you notice, I just said that 13 protons is what defines aluminum, and the 13th element on the periodic table is aluminum. The order of the elements on the table tells you how many protons each of those elements has. So the atomic number up here, which you might think at first is just, you know, it's just a numbering system to help us keep track of them, which is true, it does help us keep track of them, but it is not just a random numbering system where we just decided randomly that hydrogen was going to be 1 and helium is 2. No, those atomic numbers, the numbers at the top here, they tell us how many protons are in the nucleus of that element. And so that is true for all of these elements here on the periodic table. All right. I think we'll go ahead and call it there for this video. In the next one, we'll talk more about the periodic table, about how it's split up, what the different groups are, and things like that, and how to read a symbol, how to read the boxes on the periodic table. So I'll see you in the next video.